everyone, and welcome to this week's Sunday Stencils. Last week we had our video blog up and it was a huge success. Thank you for everyone who joined us, who subscribed, who placed an order. It was just a stunning week for us and a very busy one. Today I will be talking about stencils on cork, and as you can see there are two kinds of cork, the one with adhesive and the one without. I have some cork with adhesive from Karen Foster, and this is just amazing because the adhesive stuff on the back keeps it together, so it's easier to cut any shapes out of it. You can use a dies, or you can use a circle cutter or some scissors, just whatever you want, and the adhesive will make sure that the cork does not fall apart in all the little parts that it's made of. So I used my simple circle cutter to cut out a circle, and the first one was a little too small, so I cut out a 3¼-inch circle, and I will be using the wave of snowflake stencil from Create a Smile. And first of all, I prepped my cork with my EK6S powder tool because I will be doing some embossing on top, and I want to make sure that the embossing powder does not stick to all. Well, it is a rough surface. Cork does not have a very slick or very smooth surface, so you really want to make sure to use a powder tool first to make sure that the embossing powder only sticks where it's supposed to be. So I used some Hero Arts white embossing powder. I love that stuff. It just gives a very good impression. And as you can see, I have a very clean embossed area. So the you can really emboss on cork. It's not that difficult as long as you use the powder tool. And well, maybe you can even use some baby powder with just a paintbrush. I've never tried it, but I think this will work. So I used some Versamark again to add a second coat because the first one gave a good impression, but I wanted it to stand out a bit more. And it soaked a little bit into the cork. At least this is what it looked like. So I did another coat and lined that up, and I have a perfect impression now. And I cut out a snowflake from the Smiling Snowflake stamp set. I pre-stamped and pre-cut that with my Silhouette. And then I took three pieces of vellum because I just did not know where to stop. I think I totally overdid this card. So sorry if this is not the best card I've ever made. But, well, this is how it turned out, and it's still okay for me. So yeah, I overdid it a little bit, and I used some vellum to add some more dimension and to add some more interest. And I wanted to color them, at least two of the three strips, and I used teal Simon Says Stamp teal ink for one, and Simon Says Stamp Audrey blue for the other one. So we have some greens and blues. I think these are very beautiful colors with the cork and also for a Christmas card. And I have to say that I'm totally in love with the teal color at the moment. This may be my favorite ink of all times so far. Okay, so I used my heat gun to set that because the ink does stay wet for a little longer on the vellum because the vellum does not soak the ink very well. And then I used some adhesive to just adhere the three strips down to my cork, and then I used my scissors to cut off the excess. But I decided that I did not want to have it hanging off the panel, so I had a look and I thought no, they should not hang off the cork. And then I used I just peeled it off again and moved it a little bit to make them end on top of the cork. So this is what I ended up with. And at that point, I should have noticed that the stencil background was okay for itself. It did not need any vellum or anything else because it will be a pretty busy card for a clean and simple card. You know, I love clean and simple cards, but this is kind of busy. And then I started filling in the snowflake, just coloring with some Copics. And I used colors that match the teal very good. So I used BG09, BG34, and BG32. And I think these mint and teal colors really are a good combination. I love this three color combo a lot. And I am not a fan of going back and forth and back and forth with the same colors again, just because it takes so much time. Sometimes I like to do it, but in this case I just used the colors one time, and my cardstock where the snowflake was stamped on was bright white, but the card base, which is Samsa Stamp ultra thick cardstock, is just a little bit off-white. So I used the BG70 to have a little bit of blue shading around the snowflake to not have too many different kinds of white on my card. So I adhered that cork piece, and you want to be careful because this cork or this adhesive is very, very strong, so whenever you press that down, it will stay in place and you won't get it off again. Then I use the my dimensional adhesive for the snowflake, and many people ask me where I got this from. For the German customers, I got it from Voegner. Voegner does have it for about €6 for one roll, so it's pretty cheap. I use the German cinnamon set, or the German Christmas sentiment set, Schöne Bescherung, and picked one sentiment that says Schneeflöckchen, Weißröckchen, wann kommst du geschneit? And this is a German Christmas song for children, which means, oh little snowflake, when will you come down? Something like that. So I used that, and I stamped the first line with a teal color and the second line with some VersaFine black ink. And for a last finishing touch, well, I thought it was, I picked one of our new chipboards. This is from the Christmas Icons set, and I took this little snowflake, which matches one of the stamps in the sentiment set. And the really last finishing touch was some Wink of Stella to get some glitter onto that snowflake. And then I just used a Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pen in XS to make some changes to the sentiment that was not stamped perfectly because I had mounted it on a curve. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.